Hey filmmakers, Seungde here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build this top handle setup. It's a setup that is mainly used by a lot of skateboarders, inline skaters, or even rollerbladers. It's a setup where you can get very, very nice wide angle low and very low angle shots, and mainly used by actually following somebody who's already skateboarding and following his pace, so you can get like a nice shot when he is doing some tricks. And yeah, it's a very simple setup, so your hand is basically on top of here, so you can hold it very, very low to the ground. Here I added a Rode FeederMic Pro on the back here. The reason why it's on the back is because most of people use a very, very wide angle lens. If I actually add an adapter here and put it on here, it might actually easy or get in the shot, which is not that great. Another extra thing I've added here is the Kabuto focus. And the thing is, I can hold it with one hand and with the same hand also control the focus. You might think you can only have like a little bit or not a lot of movement you can make with the thumb, because you can't move a big distance with it. It's not a big problem on this setup because the lens is mostly a very wide angle lens, and it actually only has to move a very short distance to get to infinity or to the closest focus. It's mainly if you are following the guy and you can able to get really, really close by, that you can at least change the focus a little and not have to use your other hand to change the focus, because you might lose your balance, while mostly you'll be using the other hand to help counterbalance yourself. It's a recommended setup to use with a camera that has a flip out screen, because you won't be able to look at the monitor because it's very low and not on your eye height. So you'll be either, if you're not using one with a monitor, you're basically shooting blind, and with a monitor you are able to see what you're filming and also maybe use like focus peaking, so you can know if your focus is right or not. But mostly from the top, most lenses will have like markers, so you can see if it's on infinity or on which kind of distance. So that was mainly explaining most of this, and it's a very simple setup. So let's go to build. The main part is the L brackets. Add a sponge handle. Actually, this setup costs you probably 16 bucks. Mainly, this is the most basic setup. You can put your camera directly on here, and also you can add a quick release. Now you have a setup that costs 26 bucks. If you want to add a microphone, you need to change the setup a bit. Put this all the way around. So over here, add a ball head. Right now you have added a extra quarter inch where you can screw something on. However, for my Rode FeederMic, I need to add a cold shoe mount. So yeah, that was basically the setup. It's very simple, small, and easy to break apart and put it in your bag so it's smaller. So that was mainly it, how to build this setup. It's a very simple build, and also not a lot of materials or accessories that you need to add. And yeah, that was mainly it. So hopefully you like this video, and please subscribe. If you have any questions, please comment below. And also, we are now having an Indiegogo campaign for this Kabuto Focus, because this is not really on the market yet. And yeah, it really helps out if you are filming these kind of shots and have this kind of setup, because otherwise you really need to use your other hand to change the focus. So check out the links below to go to the campaign of the Kabuto Focus. Also might have an annotation somewhere on the screen. And yeah, that was mainly it. And my name is Seungde, and thank you for watching.